Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
That is the flames and mesh management. My topic is regarding to quantification and the identification of. Purely basic on pure subject, chemistry and physics. Generally, we are utilizing some equipments in field, pH conductivity measurements, and spectrophotometric equipments. We are many of the equipments we are importing and utilizing in our life. But we can't think about the cost and the technique. Is it available at our level and we can make this equipment or is it possible or not? Generally, for in electrochemistry, there is chemical law, Faraday's law. It is current and potential related to power.
Hello, okay.
Faraday is equivalent to 96,500 resembling to Avogadro number. In electrochemistry, the Faraday law is used for displacement of metal or material. How it is useful in our laboratory measurements? It is used for current measurements, electromagnetic and electrolytic cells, and standby power sources in our spectra, like that. Similarly, cadmium
cells are used. We are using. These are used for
reference electrodes. Over voltage concept is used for polarographic technique to identify continuously. We are increasing the potential. The potential is making a ramp at our observation. The ramp indicates the elements present and the volume of material present. Virtual resistant, a rapid alternative current about 1000 times per second to eliminate polarization of electrodes due to direct current. It is used for conductivity measurements. Because at constant potential, it is some other difficulties arises, that is power putting the scaling on, that is oxidizing of the electrodes, and the conductivity decreases. One more thing is material transportation. These points are eliminated by applying alternating current to the electrodes. Similarly, concentration cells. These are also used for measuring. How can we measure? Because if we measure, we are using chloride as a component in measurement activity. Then, how can we estimate chloride? In electrochemistry, pH is glass electrode. Similarly, fluoride sensitive glass electrode is used. It has fluoride standard concentration. The less than accepts the transportation of chloride, then the concentrations based on concentrations outside and inside concentrations, the chloride ion movement is there. It generates a potential at the cell. It is measured. Generally, in spectrochemistry, spectroscopy, we are using atomic absorption spectroscope, partial theory in it. One analyte is atomized in a flame. It generates three ions. These three ions generate a specific energy spectrum. Parallelly, we are generating a spectrum of the same frequency. That spectrum is passed to the atomized ions. Linking to the spectrum, the ions are absorbing that spectrum lines, and the absorbance is we are measuring. Visible spectrophotometer also applying the same, but it is liquid. Similarly, ICP, inductively coupled to plasma, there is plasma is higher temperature rising. It emits the spectrum lights, spectrum of different lights. Regarding to that element, what we have to measure, these elements are identified as the concentration, the best concentration lines of. Then IR radiation is also based on the spectrum lines. The generation of different variations are based on the temperatures and the technique, because IR radiation is generated, a separate technique is used. That is, similarly in semiconductors, we are using semiconductors. Previously, we are using large cathode ray tubes only. Previously, we are using cathode ray tubes. Diodes, triodes, tetrodes, pentodes are the names of some tubes. The electron flow is controlled by the guided electrodes. Similarly, AC alternating current flow, DC current also prepared with the diode. Later, when solid state physics and solid state materials comes into picture, the volumes enormously decreased and the power consumption also decreased to thousands to one in decimal points. These semiconductor materials generally they are carbon group elements. Silica and adjacent to the silica are used for semiconductor materials. The materials, elements have semiconductor properties of silicon, germanium, tin. The doping elements aluminium, gallium, indium, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. Some materials have oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, and tin, cadmium, and metal. These are all used for semiconductor material generation processes. In surface chemistry, we are using adsorption and absorption techniques. Adsorption is based on absorption, the thin layer chromatography, high-pressure liquid chromatography, ion chromatography, and gas chromatography equipments are prepared. Based on Tyndall effect, that is the immiscible suspension, the immiscible particle size 0.2 micrometer to 5 micrometer are considered. For this technique is used for estimation of sulfate. Kendall effect, based on Kendall effect, nephelometers and calcimeters are prepared. In gas law, PV equal to RT based pressure gauges are prepared under the application. Thermodynamic laws also having application in generation of equipment. Measurement of heat capacities, change of state, latent heat and evaporation, latent heat of evaporation and emissions are based on first law thermodynamics. The second law, the thermodynamic is used for preparation of air conditioners and heat transfer equipment. Now, generally in laboratory, some equipments we are in use. For example, we take hot air balloon. It is used a simple technique, only heater and temperature control. For temperature control, there are so many equipments are there. One is importing these hot air balloons at the cost of so many lakhs. It could be an indigenized and locally prepared. Similarly, muffle furnace also. Generally, in muffle furnace, we are using 650 temperature, degrees centigrade temperature. In muffle furnace, there are imported out there. They are using sophisticated electronic circuit for 0.1 degree or 1 degree changes. For such narrow changes are not required for muffle furnace. 5 degree temperature change is not a remarkable change for muffle furnace application. Then it is also to be indigenized and locally to be prepared. It requires sophistication. Some parts are maybe generated indigenously and some are imported equipment required for precision control. We have to develop that capabilities. This presentation is mainly based on for the purpose of how to modify or how to indigenize the equipment we are using. For noise measurement, we are using importing noise meters with a cost of lakhs, but in small our cell phone can be act as noise with a small app. It is free to download. It would act as our cell phone is acted as noise meter. The calibration system also there, but a calibrator, external calibrator is sufficient to calibrate it and use it as noise meter. Then we are saving a much amount in the name of equipment. And the every smartphone become a noise meter. If required, it would be act as noise meter. Similarly, we have to develop applications, apps, and the techniques, both for lower cost of equipment and the free availability to our user and public user. I pay my thanks for this opportunity to our customers. I have both the equipment and the preparation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.